Viewers and subscribers, welcome to the Coach's Desk again. And today we have in studio Kimani Decombre, former Excelsior and Charlemont High School football player. We'll be talking some football with Kimani. Kimani, how are you doing?
I'm good. You're taking it easy. How are
you? Good, sounding good. Now, we're going to jump right into the interview, Kimani. So I'm going to ask you to tell our viewers and subscribers, how did you get involved in football?
First and foremost, I just want to thank God that we're able to talk here today, you know. And also share with the viewers and subscribers that you were my first coach, Mr. Menzi, you know, first ever coach back in primary school. You know, we were just 9 years old, you know, kicking and running and chasing our dreams. But for basically, how I got involved with football, I mean, I was born in a football family, you know. Football was the only topic growing up, outside kicking with all the friends and family all day long, every day, you know, until primary school. You know, we start watching television, seeing it on the TV, wanting to get a taste of that dream. And then I met you at grade 4. You know, and you start training us and teaching us about the game. And then that's when I played the first competitive game, you know.
All right, awesome. We understand, Kimani, that your dad and your brother were also great footballers. Could you shed some light on that?
I mean, yeah. You know, my dad was very great, you know, in his time. He played. He was playing Major League Soccer at the age of 15, but he left the country, you know, and I guess things didn't turn out too well for him, but, you know, he was pretty good in his days, you know. And my brother, the talent spread right through the family. He was also a very good soccer player, but I don't think his dream was, you know, to play soccer, but he had the talent. He was very skillful, very talented, you know. So I guess it's just in the family, you know. It's just just in the blood, I guess.
All right, I hear that, man. Now, you said that things didn't work out for your dad, it didn't work out for your brother. But you're on that path to make football your dream, right?
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. Now, on that journey to your dream, you were playing Doncaster Cup football for Charlemont High School. And the last 2 years that you had, you made a switch to Excelsior. Tell us about that.
Okay. Firstly, I can go back to the Costa Cup, and you know, I can say the biggest change or the biggest impact the switch from the Costa Cup to Manning Cup had on me was the environment. You know, the yeah. Change of mentality in the environment, in the youths that surround me.
Okay.
In the Costa Cup, nobody knew how to address the fact, say that we're trying to go pro.
Yes.
So we're trying to go college, you know, we're trying to get a scholarship. Nobody knew. I mean, I didn't even know that was a thing. Like, I was able to control that, you know, until I left and get to to Excelsior.
Yes.
Excelsior now, the youths, everyone around us, you know, all they wanted to do was to go pro or to go get a scholarship and go to university to play. So they had that playing for, you know. So I think that's the only, switching from not knowing to knowing was the biggest change. And then, you know, the things that you have to do, you know, to keep that level to be able to compete with the guys from Kingston who was playing for something, you know, who know what they was playing for, you know. So that was the biggest change to me. I mean, Otherwise, the talent, the talent gap wasn't really wide. You know, the talent was close between kids from Charlemont and kids from Excelsior, but it's just what we were playing for that was the difference. Yeah. You know.
Yeah. Charges down there would have had an aim or a motivating factor, something to play for, an end result, not only to win Manning Cup, but the fact that they would get a scholarship. Now, could you shed some light on that scholarship that you made mention of? You got a scholarship for United States. Talk to us about that.
Okay, you know, my move to Excelsior opened up a lot of doors, you know. I was invited to become a member of the Ballers International Academy. Mm-hmm. You know, I was exposed to a lot of people, you know, the Excelsior management staff, the coaches, you know, they had a lot of connections.
Yes.
So the Ballers Academy, the coaches, Coach Andre, you know, Coach Gilbert from Excelsior, the management staff, the surrounding environment created the doors, you know, created all the opportunities and showed us how. So all we had to do was, you know, play and perform well, get our highlight videos, and then you just contact the coaches from, you know, overseas and the schools you're interested in. You contact them, you let them know, hey, this is it, you know, and that's where the process begins.
Yes.
So coming here now in the US, it was, you know, it was a dream come true, but it was also a big risk because, you know, you're leaving everyone behind coming to chase your dream. So you never know what's going to happen next. Yeah, you know, every day is another journey. Every day is another step of the journey, and it's just a new day. You don't know what's going to happen. But I think my first year at Ranger College, it was a great year, you know. Played very well. We went to the conference finals. It was good. It's a lot more competitive, but then at the same time, it's a wider variety of, like, it's on a larger scale, you know. You have to try your best to be on top and to stay there, you know.
Definitely. So, definitely that move to Excelsior would have opened up some doors of opportunity for you. And we here at Coach's Desk, we are definitely happy for you, Kimani. Now, is the Manning Cup and the Costa Cup helping the youngsters who are talented in Jamaica?
Yes, I think so. Because firstly, I'm here, you know, and I played both Manning Cup and the Costa Cup. But, you know, the bridge is already created. You know, a lot of players are here from Jamaica who was playing Manning Cup and the Costa Cup. But I think the only issue is, or the only thing we need to work on is how to strengthen that bridge, you know. Or to strengthen the bridge so that more, a higher ratio of players make it out from Jamaica to Europe or to America, you know, to go pro or to go university, you know. So I definitely think that Manning Cup and the Costa Cup is helping students, you know, helping players because they're players here, you know, they're players here. But my only wish or dream is to be able to help to strengthen that bridge so that more players are able to get provided the opportunity, you know?
Yeah, well said. Now, Kimani, what position do you play? For the viewers and subscribers who don't know.
I'm a left winger, out and out striker. Left winger and out and out striker, you know. Growing up, I was a right midfielder, you know. I played right midfield and for primary school for Charlemont. And then arriving at Excelsior, I started playing left midfield. So you know, I started being more all-rounded, you know. But since I got here playing for Ranger College, I've been striking for Ranger College, you know, and I'm getting to like being a striker more, you know. I think it suits me, my playing style more.
Okay.
So for now, I'm striking for Ranger College, you know.
Awesome. And do you have any plans of playing professional football?
Well, definitely. That was a dream since the beginning, you know, to play pro and represent a club and to be able to further my journey, you know. That was since the beginning.
And that part of that journey would be playing for the national football team?
Definitely. To represent my country would be, you know, a great honor to wear that black, green and gold, you know, put on that jersey and to stand and listen to the national anthem playing. So definitely I would love to represent my country and to try and do my best to make my country proud.
Awesome, wonderful. Now, Kimani, we're out of time. Encourage a youngster out there who want to take football to the next level.
For all the youngsters out there who want to take soccer to the next level, take football to the next level, I would say start doing research, you know. Start trying to locate that bridge, you know, because that's the most important part, you know. Find out where you want to go and locate the bridge that leads to that destination. Because a lot of young youths have a great talent in Jamaica. I mean, when I look at the quality at home and the quality here, it's like Jamaicans, a lot of Jamaicans have an enormous load of talent, but they don't know how to locate that bridge that we talked about earlier. And that's the key, you know, that's the key to find a way to locate that bridge so you can cross it. A lot of young Jamaicans, they're just playing and just playing for playing's sake, you know, playing with all the dreams and the hopes, just lingering in the back because they don't know where that bridge is for them, you know.
Yes.
So I would say, you know, reach out, you know, talk to your coaches, talk to whoever you can. Don't be afraid to get your word out there and find the information that you need. You know, you always need the highlight videos for those who want to come to universities. You know, you always need to have proof that you're playing because no one is watching us. You know, we have to get our records and be able to present them, you know. And also keep at it, keep going, keep training. You know, never lose faith, never lose hope.
Well said, Kimani Dikombre. And thank you very much for joining us today here on the Coach's Desk. It was a privilege. And we just want to tell you, as you continue your journey, all the best. We wish you all the best. And we hope that you realize all those dreams that you have there. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you very much. You too.
Thanks.